Filipinos rediscover their love affair with Filipino flavors this week as the country's long-running and biggest export-oriented food show, IFEX Philippines, returns on site. Joining us are two participating entrepreneurs, Alme Gao C, CEO and founder of Oh So Healthy, and Ian Paradis, founder of Encanto Brewery. Alme, Ian, thank you so much. Welcome to Market Edge. Hi.
Good morning, Mimi. Thank you for having us.
All right, so big week. I mean, how critical is the food trade show for your brands to grow and reach more markets abroad? I understand this isn't your first rodeo with IFEX, right?
Yes, for me anyway. I will start.
Go ahead.
If you don't mind. We joined in 2019, and we would have joined again 2020. Unfortunately, COVID happened. So it's nice that IFEX again is reintroducing it this year, so there's quite that excitement from all the local manufacturers.
Ian, how critical would a trade show like this be for your brand?
Well, one, it's just great to see kind of the industry being able to get back, you know, presenting themselves not just as local manufacturers and sellers, but also to bring our products out to the rest of the world. So this is a great way to kind of showcase our products. And we're super excited to be participating in IFEX this 2022.
All right. And Alme, I want to go to you. Aside from Oh So Healthy, you're a contract manufacturer. 20 years manufacturing a wide range of products from food, home care, personal care products for some of the well-known MNCs like Unilever, Del Monte, and P&G. I'm very curious, from your vantage point, how's demand been in the last 6 to 12 months of reopening? And are your production levels back to 2019 pre-COVID highs already?
So 2019 was supposed to be the big year that we launched everything. We in fact, used IFEX as a platform to go to Winter Food Fancy, meet international buyers. And we were so geared up 2020 to start supplying Costco. And then all of a sudden, COVID happened and derailed our plans. And as you know, during COVID, all the buyers locally did not want to engage with brands that are not critical. So they only wanted to engage with big brands. And it took a real big setback. 2021, the setback was high shipping cost. So this 2022, we've all put our minds together and said, this is the year that, you know, we're really going to trailblaze. And it's, to me, also the most opportune time because there's a big awareness and consciousness about healthy living and the snacks that we eat. So hopefully that we can further advocate and tell the world about what Oh So Healthy is about and why we're pushing this brand to everyone.
Alme, as an aside, I'm curious, for your contract manufacturing, are your production levels back to pre-COVID levels outside of the Oh So Healthy brand? Just very quickly.
Yes. So, honestly, COVID was one of the years that we did not stop, not for Oh So Healthy, but for my clients. In fact, it's a very strong year because everyone stayed at home. Household brands such as Del Monte, they had to eat at home, right? Maybe not for personal care products, but definitely for food. So the reverse. This year, we're seeing a lot of food service industry products increase.
All right. And from food, let's go to drinks. Ian, you're sold in major groceries and marts. How much of your sales, I'm curious, are actually from delivery and online sales?
So actually, it's quite a similar story to Alme's and her business in the sense that, as you could imagine, 2020, 2021 were extremely tough. Outside of being considered, you know, FMCG, we were also, we produce alcoholic beverages. So between stringent kind of lockdowns and liquor bans in multiple cities, it was a super tough 2 years. And we literally went from being almost 100% of our trade sales driven by on-trade volume, which is on-premise. So hotels, restaurants, and bars, we had to pivot almost to fully off-trade, which is groceries and through our e-commerce site. So right now, though, the great thing is, and as Almay mentioned as well, things are picking up again. So now we're seeing a lot of our on-trade business come back, which is super exciting. Restaurants and bars are starting to reopen and come back to life. Volumes really picking up. So for us, it's been a great last few months in the sense we're hitting our pre-pandemic levels, volumes. But it's a better balance between our on-trade and off-trade sales.
All right. For both Almay and Ian, and this is where I want to end the conversation, clearly you guys have something great to offer. The DTI has been staging these expos to try to push you into the global stage. What else would entrepreneurs like yourselves need to build the Philippine brand? I mean, you think Germany, it's about durable machines. You think made in Japan, it's high-tech quality. You think made in South Korea, it's they're known for makeup and K-pop. What about the Philippines? Aside from being known for our labor, how do we push Philippine Inc. through products like what you offer? Let's start with Almay and then we end with Ian. Almay?
Sure. For me, I think we should really focus on agri. Mm-hmm. Not only because I use a lot of our naturally home ingredients, but I think, you know, mangoes in the Philippines, they're still the best in the world, or bananas. So if we focus on agri, that there's a big need in the world. And the rest, I think, as you mentioned earlier, tourism, because the best talents in the Philippines is really catered towards
all right,
the hospitality. Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. Ian, just very quickly.
Yeah, for us as well, we recently relaunched our brand, you know, with a new logo and new products. And one of the core ideas there was to be able to incorporate what we feel are incredible local products that don't really get the attention around the world. So with two of our beers, our newer variants, one of them incorporates mango from Guimaras, and the other incorporates honey from a combination of farms from Bukidnon and Baguio, which we're really proud of. So this allows us to, of course, showcase products that us Filipinos were super proud of, and that we feel the rest of the world doesn't really get to fully enjoy yet. So that's been super exciting, and the reception from the consumer has been incredible.
All right, we're looking forward. All right, good to hear. Guys, thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations and good luck with the expo. Thank you for joining us today.